Thank you very much. As has been already explained, the team of observers who will come will be an expanded team. It won't be the usual number of observers that are sent to any country, so that they can cover as much as possible. They will never be able to cover all polling stations, but they would be able to go even to the remotest places. What does ECOWAS have for Guinea and Cote d'Ivoire? ECOWAS will continue to monitor the situations, continue to engage in dialogue with all the actors, all the stakeholders, to ensure that there is peace. It's not just Guinea and Cote d'Ivoire that are going for elections before the end of year. Ghana as well, Niger and Burkina Faso. ECOWAS has its hands full to make sure that it engages all these countries, all the political actors, to ensure that by the end of the year, we have the elections in all these countries, and the elections are free, fair, and non-violent. Thank you. On the seizure of the paraphernalia of the opposition candidate, when he had his engagement with us, he did mention it, and it is something that we took note of, and we have raised it with the appropriate quarters, and we hope that a solution will be found very soon, and so we will continue to monitor the situation. On the closure of the borders with other countries, we have also taken note of that. We have raised it with the authorities. However, let us not forget that the airports to the country are open at the moment. Most countries anyway have closed their land borders still, even though the airports are open. And it is for the government to determine what the security situation is, including the situation of COVID-19. And so government, I believe, will be assessing all these issues, and then they'll take a decision on it. But we did take note of that. Also, when we met His Excellency Alpha Conde, the President of the Republic, we gave him an overview of all the meetings that we've had over the last 2 days, and the issues of concern that were raised by the various groups that we met. And indeed, he was very explicit in letting us know that he does not in any way encourage any form of violence, that he's committed to a peaceful election, and that he is the last person to encourage acts of violence during electioneering campaigns. And therefore, in short, he showed clearly his commitment to ensuring that this campaign, the elections, and the aftermath of elections are very peaceful. I think that the last one is to do with
the candidacy, the FNDC,
Roger Manuel.
The FNDC's
question is the group that we
Roger Manuel.
Yes, we did meet them yesterday, the FNDC, and they did have their concerns. They made their concerns very known to us. And at this point, you are 2 weeks to elections. I believe that we've moved past all these issues of third term bid. The Constitutional Court has cleared all the candidates for the election, and it is well known to the citizens of Guinea. What is now left is for the citizens of Guinea to go to the ballot and choose their leader. So I believe we've gone past that at this stage, we've gone past that completely. And with 2 weeks to elections, I think the citizens of Guinea must go into the election and make their choice. So if the third term is an issue for them, then of course they would use their thumbs, their vote to speak. And I think that's which we should be forward looking in this instance. Thank you. ECOWAS has announced that it will send a team of observers to observe the elections here, and I'm sure that there may be other observers, whether it's civil society or whatever. But the point is, when it comes to the conduct of the elections, there are mandated institutions that are supposed to monitor, to ensure that everything goes well. And I think that is up to the institutions in the country. So we would expect the institutions, whether it's SENI, whether it's in case that there is any dispute, the Constitutional Court, they are all placed and they have all assured us that they will do what is expected of them to ensure that the elections are free, fair, and transparent. What we are doing now is all part of what we can do coming from outside institutions such as ECOWAS, the AU, and UN. We will continue to engage in dialogue, but the bulk of the work that needs to be done has to be done by the Guinean authorities and the political parties and civil society and any stakeholder or actor who has a stake in the process. Thank you.